One of the milestones of becoming an adult with an office job is the day you get your own desk. You can put pictures of your family up. You can put your feet up. But sometimes sitting at that fancy desk comes with an unwanted bonus of a little back pain with a matching slouch. That was until a team of innovators realized many workers were demanding a desk made for standing. Here's Albert Lawrence to explain.
It might be hard to believe, but the idea of a stand-up desk is nothing new. It's rumored Leonardo da Vinci used a stand-up desk while he painted the Mona Lisa. Maybe that's why she's smiling. But at the start of the 20th century, it became fashionable to sit behind a desk, and many reports suggest we've been suffering for it ever since. In fact, it was chronic back pain that gave birth to a new idea.
It all started with a cardboard box, literally walking into my colleague's office. He would stand at his desk with a cardboard box on top of it with his laptop. And I said, what are you doing? He said, well, I've got back pain and I just feel better when I stand up.
I made the trip to Dallas, Texas to meet David Patton and Jason McCann, who took the laptop on a box idea and innovated a breakthrough piece of office furniture called Varidesk.
This is actually some of the ideation sketches that I did to kind of figure out how we wanted the mechanism to work. When you think about the two arms, you know, we wanted to put a spring in there, the tensioning of it. We worked through a lot of different ideas.
David started drawing and designing and creating mechanism ideas of how we could lift a computer quickly without bolting anything down to a desk. No assembly required. Then a prototype for us is like a newborn, a little rickety and wobbly, and it wasn't quite perfect, but we saw beauty in it.
So Albert, this is our original prototype. In order to operate it, we designed it with two handles. That way it made it easy to operate and also would keep any of the user's appendages away from the mechanism. It was a conscious choice that what you could do with very little effort is squeeze the handles, actually keep your arms firm, and actually use your body weight to pull this back versus actually having to do a muscular lift. We ultimately came up with what I've always called the booster spring. Gives you a boost, starts that kind of a inertia there to get you comfortably through the rest of the lift.
David also worked on design improvements, including lifting the desk and keyboard tray concurrently and carving out an ergonomic curve.
You align the desk to the edge of the desk. What that allows you to do is step into the lift without bending your back, keep your back straight, grab the handles, and do the lift.
For those who choose not to or are unable to do any lifting, Varidesk created an electric version that can raise a desk over 4 feet high, which someday might inspire you to write as good as stand-up desk lover Ernest Hemingway. Oops, sorry. I mean write as well as Hemingway.